the past 2 months, in fact, the past couple of years, have been a whirlwind for one particular hip-hop artist who has been blowing up the charts. To talk to us more about the man being called possibly the new king of hip-hop is our own king of the radio, Johnny Rocket. Hey, Johnny.
That sounds absolutely, I mean, I like it, I'll take it. Thank you for that, but I don't know if it's that deserved, but whatever, we'll go with it, go, sure, why not?
So the person we're talking about is Lecrae, whose new album, Anomaly, is getting a lot of attention. Have you heard it?
I got a pre-screening, but it was phenomenal from the start. It was controversial from the start. And that man definitely makes me look up my Urban Dictionary a little bit, trying to figure out what do some of these words actually mean.
He talks a lot about his life. Like, I would say this is probably one of the most candid albums that he's released. He talks about being abused as a child. He talks about his girlfriend getting an abortion. And through it all, obviously, Jesus is the center of the whole album. But very, very candid, wouldn't you say?
The one thing, actually, if you listen to one of his crew members, Andy Mineo, he says, when you talk like Jesus, everybody loves you. When you walk like Jesus, now everybody wants to judge you. Yeah. And the thing is that he is totally, he's feeling that, because as soon as he's real and he's saying, listen, I did this, I know what my struggles are, but I know that I got a God that forgives me for it. And then all of a sudden people are like, well, you know, why are you hanging out with this guy? Why are you doing this? It just makes, there's so much negativity on a guy where we should be lifting him up.
Yeah. I mean, he has really blown up. Like, he was on The Tonight Show recently, singing with The Roots. He's been covered by secular magazines as well as Christian magazines, like Vibe magazine's been doing articles on them, even ESPN. And now he's on tour, and he's just selling out stadiums everywhere.
Well, and the thing is that for a guy who's 34, he's making such an impact in an industry that, you know, people think is sometimes very corny when it comes to not only just Christian music, but Christian hip hop in itself. And a guy who's not only able to do very well in the Christian industry, but in the secular industry, it's quite amazing to see that he's, you know, number one on iTunes, yeah, that he's been on Billboard, like you said, hosting Dove Awards, he was on The Tonight Show. And not only that, he is bringing along all of his other buddies with Reach Records.
Yeah. So what's your prediction? Do you think he's going to continue on the rise? What do you think is going to happen to Lecrae in the next year or two?
I remember him saying something that he feels as though he's opened the doors for somebody who else is going to be coming through. There's a number of artists who, you know, opened the gates for him, like Cross Movements, yeah, or LA Symphony. He's paving the way for that next artist. So he's kind of opening up all the other doors, and then there's going to be another Lecrae type guy coming in, and he's going to blow through all the doors, and you never know, could be the king of hip hop.
Well, we'll hope and see. I just feel urged to pray for him. I think there's just so much attention on Lecrae right now. Everybody wants a piece of him. I know, and just recently we caught up with him here in Toronto, and you know, his circle is starting to grow. I remember back in the day, just years ago, when we were covering Rock the River, Lecrae was around and nobody was around him. He didn't have a big crew at all. And now we're slowly seeing him grow. So I just feel an urge to pray for him and just pray for God's covering on him and his family.
Amen. I love that, Megs.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, Johnny.